Alright. Feel like Blitzball is kind of a bust, to be honest. Takes a long time, and it just wasn't that fun. So, I guess we're on the monster train. What are we still missing? It's like one from Jose, right? Yeah. And then... might be... kind of it for a bit. Oh yeah, they've got the one in the cave. And then, yeah, inside Sin, an Omega Dungeon. I'm surprised I still have so many species that I haven't caught all of everything for. With just that few left. There must be a lot of repeat species inside of either Sin or Omega Dungeon. Originals. There's some messed up stuff out there. Let's go screw around in Jose for a bit, I guess. See if we can't root out that last monster. I think I've got it written down which ones I've seen and which ones I haven't yet. Yeah, okay, okay. I'm guessing it's just some random thing in an encounter I never got, but we shall see. The encounter table has a kind of funny sense of things. Alright, I don't know if I have all my capturing stuff on. I assume not. I guess Tito's still telling me. Oh yeah, I do. Actually, I also just don't want to fight these things. This is all stuff that I've seen, yeah? Well, these aren't even... yeah, these aren't even Jose monsters yet. Live and let live. I assume this is just, like, the extension of Mushroom Rock. Until I get over here. A likely story. I don't know why the Jose High Road teleport doesn't just take you right here to the actual High Road portion of the program. Even this, I think, is actually still Mushroom Rock monsters, though. Oh, which means I shouldn't be fighting them, actually. I mean, like, I can, but this is not really a point. Get some spheres. I don't know when the actual, like, Jose monsters kick in, or if it is just, like, this area has a weird mix of, like, these sorts of monsters and...
I won't go so easy on you next time.
Like, properly High Road-specific monsters. We're in the awkward bleeding over period. Yeah, like, Basilisk is a... like, a legit Jose-exclusive monster or whatever. Is that Fungwars or not? Farewell. So yeah, it's kind of a weird mix even within that of like, it's not totally consistent within any given encounter what you're gonna get. Which makes this an even more annoying process, unfortunately. Because now I have to keep an eye out, even if I'm fighting sort of non-Jose monsters. One of them might be the one I want. Farewell. Go off, Tidus, go off. Oh yeah, so I haven't finished all of those types of monsters yet. There's gotta be one of those in Omega Ruins. They seem like a great endgame dungeon type enemy.
I'll be right back.
Or maybe in Sed Sim. I'm curious to see what's in Sed Sim. I hadn't really thought that much about what's this direction? Or what's which way? Oh yeah, so this is just the temple where they chase me away. Yeah, so this is all stuff that I've fought before. Oh, maybe not the... Oh yeah, Bunyip. It just doesn't look like it should be called Bunyip, so I doubted it at first. Seemed unlikely. Seems dubious. Are there encounters here even? Oh, now we can go back to temples. They still ran to me, but not with hostility in their hearts. Not seem like there are random encounters here. This seems to be a peaceful place. I do like that everybody is cheering for us now, though. That feels pretty good. I guess we'll just sort of do some laps here. See if we can shake loose whatever this last monster is.
Live and let live.
And then if not, maybe I need to look in the Moonflow. No idea how many battles I need to go through for it to be like reasonable to
enough
to determine that we've done what we need to, or like, you know, we've exhausted the encounters. The bird? Simmer? I'm sure he's got the ram weapon on. Yeah. Thought so, but it'd be embarrassing if I missed out on this. exactly the wrong thing. Awkward. Now I'll attack the right thing. Booyah! Where's the save point for this next one, I guess? I want to go see if that was the last thing I needed. The final bird. Or the final monster, rather, was the bird. That is so far away still. I wonder if I should just run back the on the high road. I guess this has some of the same monsters, so maybe it's a good place to keep exploring just to make sure that I make sure that I'm sure. Bugs I've gotten.
I won't go so easy on you next time.
Those are a known quantity, and Ochus. Was the simmer with? It was with just some other random stuff. It was like with the Garm and some other randos. Yeah, I think it was like one of these types of encounters. Just the Ice Blonde got swapped out. But I feel like I've seen that Ice Blonde variant so many more times comparatively. Got the rare monster drop. Yeah, I thought going through the moon flow would be the fast way. I was mistaken. That's okay. Taking a stroll down the moon flow. I still not found any more simmers though. Which makes me a little bit nervous. Mostly because it just makes me wonder if it was actually a mushroom rock monster that snuck into the encounter table. Or not snuck in, but yeah. It was just part of that weird overlap. Or maybe it does just only show up at that the end of the road part. End of the road. Forgot how long it takes to get the moonflow. I messed up. I guess it's also a good reason for me not to have teleported to the moonflow waypoint. I would have been in big trouble. I started doing some research about figuring out how to play Final Fantasy XI. It's still running. I think I vaguely knew that, but I just wanted to like check with people who actually knew before I started trying to get it set up. Airship me. But that should be interesting. I have no idea if this format will work at all with an MMO, but I figure it's worth a shot. I'll at least get some hours on it and just see what it's like. I've actually really enjoyed the sort of analog or the analogous zone in 14, Eureka, so I'm hoping that it's at least kind of fun in that regard. I have no idea how active it is, because a lot of the fun of Eureka is, like, teaming up with people on the fly and messing around and coordinating stuff, so I have heard that 11 has sort of like pretty good single player, or not single player, but you know, like quote unquote single player stuff now, where you can have like a party of NPCs that can do skill chains and stuff with you. So I think they kind of were trying to let you get more of the whole experience, even if you're not, Aha, that was the last one. Petrify grenades, pretty cool. What do you got for me? Of course. Give him the look. Feels like roughly doable though. I have no idea how much HP it has left. Oh, whoops. Oh, sometimes it gets to act multiple times. But at least like sort of has to fight fairly and just kill us one at a time, which is something encouraging anyway. Oh yeah, so we've got the... I guess we can go digging in the sunken cave and see if we can turn up the last enemy there. Just knock out the last couple of these. That'd be nice before I go into Sin. Or God forbid start trying to hunt in the Omega Ruins. But I know there's just gonna be a bunch of stuff in the Omega Ruins where it's like, oh yeah, like all of these are the last of their species, so if you want to get the species conquest, you gotta get in there. Because there's at least like a lizard in there. There's a Morble. I mean, there's a bunch of different stuff. There might be another behemoth? King behemoth or something? Yowie!
See ya!
I mean, it took me a while to get the last encounter in, Jose, so maybe this one's also just a wait-and-see angle. I mean, it better not be this. I swear. It's a lot of coin flips I have to win. Holy smokes. I just assume these things are uncapturable, so... That's kind of my thought on it so far. You got it, buddy. I wonder if it's towards the end. I mean, it felt like the Tonberry only showed up in the last room, but maybe that's also just some weird bias. I guess I'll keep trying to fight these things as I go. on the off chance that I am supposed to try to capture one some way, somehow. It seems impossible, but... this game is also just weird enough, and like that enough that I'm like, maybe, I mean... if they want you to dodge 200 lightning bolts, maybe they also want you to have to win the coin flip lottery to fill out the bestiary. I don't put anything past them, I guess is really what I'm kind of saying. I do wonder if things like ghosts have other forms, or if if they're just one-offs that are like, well, can't really do anything with these. So they're just not gonna have an arena, like, capstone enemy. About the elixir life though. They're gonna hook me up with those. I'll also keep taking these fights. Less exciting. Oh snap, are we doing it? No! We're one away! The 50-50 didn't work out. Still, getting a couple elixirs is not the end of the world, or not a bad thing at all. I don't remember what I make with those on my weapons or armor, but I feel like it's good. Whatever it is, it's a good thing. Does get to go. Disappointing. Oh, yeah, I've never found these things before, so there you go. I think, right? Oh no, I have, dang. Curses. I just haven't seen them in so long that I thought I had. Fortunately, I've got a list of things that I've seen, so... I guess I'll do another handful of encounters here, and then maybe try the back of the cave and see if that shakes anything loose. These I've also definitely fought. Yoink! I'm a little bit curious also if maybe it's in those side rooms where the treasures are? Or if there's... I don't think there's random encounters in the Chamber of the Faith. I already know that I've got these things. Done and dusted. But there might be encounters in the side rooms, and maybe that's where my last little friendo is lurking. Oh yeah, what's the... I can make stone group now, right? All these petrified grenades? Yeah! So I could use this to go beat the, whatever that guy is in the temple. Maybe I'll do that after I, finish messing around here. I love how goofy this thing looks. Like, they clearly have the ability to do higher, like, fidelity sort of stuff. But they just decided to make this guy, like, a goofy little Muppet. And that's nice. Let's try to look in the back of the temple. Yuna's getting a little bit parched. Maybe there's certain counters in here. It's entirely possible. Kind of feels that way. I assume it's the same on the other side, but you know. Gotta do a little bit of science. Check those assumptions. Okay. Assumption status checked. I guess we'll start walking back towards the, I think there's a save point in the middle. We can also check the Chamber of Faith if we're really going for the, leave no stone unturned just in case angle. We've already been here. It's just a cutscene room. Get a little cutscene. If we go back. Oh no, we can't, I see. Huh. Well, that was cool. Oh, the save point's right here. I've fought all these things. So I guess we'll just muck around in this back room for a bit and then see where that gets us. Can we pop this? Maybe not. Balaha. Some lame steals out here. Yeah, I think that was new. Let's go! We're cleaning up out here. Tell me some good news, old arena man. I do wish there was a slightly smoother on-ramp to fighting things in the arena. It feels like it's just a big cliff of difficulty. Aha! Ah, yeah, of course. Done, Tonbury. I will investigate the pockets. That's some big karma. Donald Tonbury. It is wild to think, like, what the, like, implications are. Wow, Waka falls in such a goofy-looking way, I've never noticed. But yeah, there's gotta be some sort of, like, takeout point where it's like, you need to be able to do a ton of damage late game. Like, breaking the damage limit is really just kind of the first step. I forget how much you end up actually doing by the end of the game, though. Maybe it's not that much.
You're counting on you, kid.
I guess I should go to that. It's a Bombage Temple, yeah. I just need to put stone proof on kind of whatever, right? I've only got 4 applications, unfortunately. I don't have any more arm guards. Forge. Make the super soft charge. And what? Oh, it must be like at the bottom of the list or something. Glorious arm guard.
Yeah,
So I can do this as a safety save. Just in case this ends up not working. And I would rather have all those materials back. But I'm hoping that now that I've countered the strategy, I mean, maybe this is just the level 1 counter that I've done so far. And then there will be the next level of reckoning that comes along.
What's up? Something here?
I almost got eaten by a fiend here. Payback time.
I get the picture. Alright, let's go.
I guess raising Riku more would have been also good for this. But... we'll see what we can make happen with what we've got. Oh yeah, I should be able to make some blitz stuff with this, but I don't know if I want to use anything, like, good. Dang it. This still did pretty good damage. Oops. Yeah, fine. Oh, we can actually see its HP. Could when our sensor was live. Probably should have just attacked anyway, but oh well. Oh yeah, this thing's pretty whippy. I actually probably didn't even need the whatever proof stuff. Although maybe you didn't even bother with stone stuff. I don't know. He definitely did try to stone punch me once, so maybe I just got unlucky the first time where he just went absolutely ham on it. I also did not realize how low of HP it had. It's through the door though. I guess Petrify ends up being a one-hit kill. Oh. What is this? Oh. 6 temples. Oh. So you can go back and get all these. Then I got another one. I did. Okay, I got Bahamut's ring. Oh, I seem to be short a, an Aeon by that reckoning. So I guess I'm missing a temple still. But alright, good to know, good to know. Oh, there's a chest here too. This would be down to try for some of the destruction sphere stuff. Yeah, which one? I think this is Bahamut, right? I think I got that one in Shiva's. I remember getting Shiva's for sure. But the other ones I'm a little bit less certain about. I was thinking, I was like, oh, now that the temples don't chase me away, maybe I can go back and get the other treasures. And I was like, well, why would I need to? And then it turns out to get another Aeon. I assume that's Anima? Just based on the Aeons that I know I'm missing, it's like Anima and the Maga Sisters. So I assume the last, what do you call it? The last treasure I need to get is the one from Maga Sisters. Like, it actually leads into a full-on temple puzzle. Because I didn't see anything that would remotely hint at... I guess, because Yojimbo's not even in the temple. The whole point is that it was stolen and taken away from that temple.
You're cow-
The Mihen Ruins. I can't remember where all the temples even are. I guess I could just start to say it. I don't remember which way is faster, or if there's like a particular faster way to get back to the town.
That won't go so easy on you next time.
A likely story. It'd be kind of funny if they gave these monsters actually good steel items, because you can't have steel at this early of a point in the game anyway, so they're like, well, if you come back, we'll reward you for rifling through their pockets now that you actually have the ability to do so. Because yeah, you can't even get back here for a long time, right? Because of, I don't think you can just jump on a boat randomly and be like, I'm gonna go to, I'm gonna go back and see what's going on the Besaid. I guess I did go the right way at that intersection, though. I don't know what would have happened if I'd gone right instead of left, but hopefully it wouldn't have been too bad of a run around. There's scale.
That won't go so easy.
What do I do with that, I wonder? Oh, it probably is just like the item that casts water or something like that. Not even Watera. Just water. They believed in us. Is there not a save point here? I thought there was for some reason. Boing. Oh, it condenses into a sphere. I see. Is that sphere just gone? Oh no, I can't take it. Yoink. Maybe now it's gone. Nope. I assume I have to run this all the way back up here. I assume incorrectly. I don't think there's that many places for me to put it. Got my hands full. Hold this, will you? Aha. Uh-huh. We cracked the code, team. I look forward to these three potions. That's a Yuna weapon. And the Destruction Sphere tutorial. It's pretty tight, actually. I'm a little bit curious, actually, what I'm supposed to do with these. Oh, okay. This just goes to the end. Oh, then I have to push it. Nice. Push it to the limit. I teach you a lot of the basic mechanics in here. Oh, and then this is put in a return, I assume? Kinda seems like it. Oh yeah, then it just yeets you all the way back out of the entrance. Nice. Okay, well. That's one. It's kind of fun that they have like an actual reward for, or like a cumulative reward for doing all the destruction spheres. Oh, hey. There's a save point here. Time to desperately try to remember where all the rest of the temples are. I was just at Jose, actually. So I know there's one there. And then... is there one in Mihen? Oh, there's one in Killika, that's right. Ifrit was in Killika. We can just look at him. Yeah, and then Ixion's in... on the Jose Road. Or in the Jose Temple. And Shiva... I already did, but was in Akalania. And I think Bahamut is the other one that I did actually get the Destruction Sphere for. Which was in... what's it called? I just never go there. Wherever the like church city is, the main city of the church anyway. I like that now you can see the airship parked out in the bay. Bevel, that's what it is, yeah. Still mostly nonsense to me, right? T-E-S. U-R-S? What? It's like a word scramble or something? And then... I guess I should write this down, actually. When I gathered it, what is it? Yeah, this and the another one that I think the one that I found in what do you call it? On Beaconel. Both seem like they're ciphered on top of being in Albed.
That won't go so easy on you next time.
Well, maybe you just have to jam that into the password. Machine and call it a day. I gotta go right and then up. Up and around. It's about time for a break. I'll probably get to the temple and then take a break before going puzzle mode. Electro marble. Yeah, so I assume that Anima is the one in Baj Temple. And it's the one you have to do after you've gotten all the rest of the Aeons. I think I'm close for Maga Sisters, though. I assume that there's three items you need to get through the gate in the place. There's not a save point up here. I guess they just give you the save point right before the boss fight. Maybe there's one inside. There is, nice. Alright, break time, and then puzzle time. Alright. Let's do a fire trial. Solve some fire puzzles. I think this was another one where I basically had it figured out, and then I accidentally went to the end, and then it was like, well, too bad. No take-backsies. So I think they go pretty easy on you the first couple times. Yeah, they're like, look, it's a sphere, and a sphere-shaped recess. What could it mean? Push this right. It's just an immobile pedestal. I need to extinguish it by taking the sphere. Thought it was just gonna do its own thing for a bit. This is a pushable one, right? Yeah. The glyph repels me. How dare. Repels me yet again. It's not having anything put in there. I don't have to power the glyph somehow with this sphere? I truly don't remember. I might have to stick it onto the pedestal and then drive the pedestal into the wall. I'll try that next. I have to touch the glyph first, obviously. Does it take the glyph sphere over there? Yeah, what happens if I take it out here though? Nothing. Just thought I would ask. Aha! Found the destruction sphere. Assume this goes in one of the walls or something? I'll try it in all the places I've been so far before getting too wild with it. Okay. I wonder if I have to push the sphere there or something? Cause I don't think it can go downstairs. Or the, I don't think the pedestal can go downstairs, really. So I assume this is the end of the chamber. Yeah, that sounds a lot like a you solve the puzzle jingle. Is this relight on fire if I put this in here? It does. Well, I don't care. So I don't have any more glyph spheres. There's only the one. I wonder if I need to take this one out to the front room where the first one was. Is there like a little indentation for it, I wonder? Although, I shouldn't need the spear, right? Also, there's not really an invitation for it. I can still see if I can push it out. I don't know if I can get it down those stairs even. And this only has one slot on it, right? Can't put anything in there, I think. Yeah, it's not. Does not want to go down the stairs. I assume I need to put it under the pad, but maybe. I don't know a lot of other places I can put it at this point. Oh, maybe it's stuck there now. It'd be kind of annoying if I have to reset. But the fact that it, like, clicked in definitely makes me think that I need to do something with it here, but I don't know what. Aha! Ahaha. I mean, this makes basically no sense, but you know what? We got there. Now we gotta go destruction spear that thing. And we're running out of slots for these spheres. The greatest challenge of all, juggling spheres. I guess spheres almost always come from, like, recesses, so you always have some. Although I destroyed one of them here. I guess I also destroyed the spear with it, so.
No.
Look at that treasure. Red armlet. Come on, right then. Pretty good. Full elemental resists. Seems decent. Seems quite decent. Alright, so now it's Ixion time. With its weird hovering box shenanigans. I don't think I even found the destruction sphere in here last time, because I think I found the one. I mean, you basically have to find the one in, what do you call it? In this temple. They're like, look, here's the destruction sphere. But then how to use it is the challenge. Time to run from mini encounters.
No problem.
Live and let live.
Hey, what was the thing I need for encounter 9? Asking for no reason in particular. Purifying salt. Yeah, which I have no idea where I got. I got one of them somewhere, but from where? Who knows? I assume fighting some kind of ghost type enemy. Maybe the ghosts in the sunken cave or whatever.
Live and let live.
Who knows how many of those I'd need to steal to make one encounter done. It would be quite nice though. Especially now that I've finished hunting in most of these places.
That won't go so easy on you next time.
Are not the petrified grenades what I need to make stone proof? Can you just get them here? It is. Alright. Now I feel less bad about committing them onto, what do you call it? Oh, onto the gear that I did, because it's trivial to get more.
I'll be right back.
Maybe not trivial, but it's fairly simple to get more if I want to. I could even pay for them by fighting in the arena. I guess in a similar vein, yeah, to doing the hunting roundup, it's also the stealing roundup. Going back and seeing what everything's got in its pockets along the way.
I won't go so easy on you next time.
I guess this is one of the last areas before you get Riku, so it's one of the last places that I didn't have a decent shot at, or like I didn't steal most stuff. I feel like I usually at least would check out each enemy, you know, once or so to be like, what's going on in there? What can I steal from you? Which is why I'm a little bit surprised I actually have kind of comparatively few customize options. I would have assumed that stealing from like everything that moved would give me a pretty good like coverage rate. But it feels like there's a lot of abilities still eluding me. I guess it's hard to know, because they don't tell you what you don't have, so... I do enjoy when shopkeepers don't like it if you don't talk to them across the counter. It's a nice touch. So then, is this like my last one? I think so. I guess I can go back to Bajh Temple afterwards and double check, but... I think until I can get to the last temple, then I'm in good shape.
The cloister of trials lies within.
Well, yeah. Come on, this place has somebody who asked me that. Riveting puzzle gameplay. Yeah, somehow I opened the basement, right? Does this turn this into a blister or something? Okay, I can't put a second sphere on there to do some cheeky stuff. the double thinger. Yeah, there's something that comes up from down there, right? Oh no, it's from all the way in the front room. Where's the destruction sphere then? Fly, spheres! Fly! Oh, I can't take that one with me. Kind of annoying. The destruction spheres upstairs or something? Or maybe I have to use the glyph sphere in a bunch of places? Try using it. Supercharged. No, it's not doing anything. It said its piece. It has nothing further to contribute. I respect that. I'm gonna watch this animation, it's gonna be kind of a pain though. At least this is actually a shorter thing than I remembered. Maybe there is an upstairs. So I don't think this activates and then takes me immediately to the, Chamber Trials, or the Chamber of the Faith, rather. Oh, the wall got flickery. Touch the glyph. Destruction sphere? Yeah. I'm going to insert this into various places. Take it upstairs. Yeah, there's like a little extra thing up here. Okay, I can't go back down. Well, that's good. I don't think I need to use it on any of these. I assume that if I pull the sphere out of one of these, then the whole elevator part breaks. I guess I can test that really easily. Indeed. Wait, what happens if I take the the pillar away, though. I also wonder what happens if I yeet the destruction sphere into the lightning zone. Oh, I need the glyph sphere one. Making my life difficult. Glyphified. I'm fairly certain I just need to take the destruction sphere upstairs, but I'm a little curious. Oh yeah, it just gets yeeted off into oblivion. Fair enough. Hold this for me. Oh yeah, I wanted to try pushing the pillar. I still kind of want to try it. Just for grins. As long as I'm indulging in goofy curiosity about these puzzle mechanics. Oh yeah, it just zaps it away no matter where the pedestal is. It's not safe. It's not safe anywhere. Oh, I wonder if one of the temples they're talking about is the one in frickin' Xanarkand. Doesn't seem like I can do anything with these other than just push them, I guess. So I don't think I got the bonus round treasure in Xanarkand. Although maybe I did. I feel like those were pretty simple puzzles, so it might have been nice to gone for them. Aha. We've done it. Oh, can we go talk to all the faith? Man, did I just mess up by not doing this in the last couple ones I went to? Probably. I got all sorts of goodies in here. Central location where I can get to these easily. Might as well just throw this one down and call it a day. Titus is eating. Man's is large. I guess he did just get plus 8, so that would make sense that he should be quite enormous. I guess I'll go revisit the other two real quick, now that I've got the solutions on the brain. I do want to go back to Baj Temple though and just make sure that I'm not tripping out thinking that now I've got almost all the things I need. I'll do that first and then I'll go back to...
We're counting on you.
I guess I need to go back to all of them because I need to do... Or I'd want to go to Makalania Temple as well if I'm going to be doing that. The whole group. Oh, Sin's right at the top.
Here we go.
For some reason, I thought that I needed to go to, like, Bevel or something to get to Sin, but it's not the case. It simply is not true. Surface just takes me all the way back up. Wow, it takes me all the way to the... Hang, okay. I already had that one. Okay, so yeah, I've just got one that I'm missing. But this definitely looks like Bahamut, right? Purple. They seem roughly color-coded? Just like Shiva. I guess I don't know. This, I guess this is Valifor? And then Bahamut. Ixion. And, Ifrit. And this one's yellow like Yojimbo, but I don't think I can get to his, his chamber. And six temples. I assume that I have to come here after I do the Mega Sisters. Yeah, I don't remember seeing extra credit puzzles in in Xanarkand, but I can have that as a last resort place to check if for whatever reason, because like, you know, it might be the opposite. It might be that, like, for whatever reason, Anima gates the Maga Sisters because I need to, like, get Anima to then, you know, have the last duel with the lady. See if I can find those runes right on top of the save. Maybe I need a password for those. Oh yeah. I guess would these just fit as their own whole thing? WRS. I've got room for this whole thing. Yeah, I'm a couple letters short. Speedrun this cloister after I run my ass all the way back. Oops. Including taking the wrong turn first. Off to a ripping start. Let's see where this takes us. I think it just like loops us around to the beach eventually. flower. Yeah, I can like swim around and then I think it does spit me out of the beach. Preemptive flight. I'll never know I was here.
I won't go so easy on you next time.
Fish, fish. I wonder what is down there that can't walk into for whatever reason. Let's get flipped around. I do not remember anything about the beginning of this game in terms of where they ran you around in this island. I guess Phoenix Downs are always pretty nice to have. Kind of a nice steel target. I gotta get into encounters. Yeah, how many, speaking of random things that I get from drops? Okay, on strength spheres. Power spheres, I guess. Usable for strength, defense, or HP. There's so much more than just a strength sphere. Touch the glyph. Maybe I do need the glyph sphere. Get out. Oh, I think I need to touch this wall. That's right. This is a weirdly obtuse, like, first dungeon puzzle thing. Oh, no, I don't need to touch the wall. Oh, I need to touch this wall. Faith me up. A lot of stuff in here. Maybe I should be talking to more random people, since they did get a bunch of dialogue updates. Everybody's talking about the airship. No, I don't want to hike all the way to Jose. Oh, it's so far. Maybe I'll go hang out in Sin for a while. Well, entering the Sin cutscene. Random sphere level suspend actually. Oh, it's unknown territory. Could be anything in here. But it's turtles. Now we're cooking. Wow, those points of strength are putting in a lot of work here, huh? Tita's achieving all-star status. I don't remember this part of going through Sin. I barely remember. I mean, from what I remembered playing when I was like younger.
I'll be right back.
I barely went inside Sin. I didn't even realize that it had like a capture log. Because all I remember is going in at the very end of the game after I'd done all the side quests. What? That's no rock. I guess I should be fighting these things. They seem like decent XP. But yeah, I just sort of, like, wandered in here after I'd done everything else, and then was like, oh, I guess I'll, just casually go win the game. They did. Boy has achieved critical mass. This is without like a strength buffing weapon too. That's actually the wild part. Stamina tablet. Oran has a lot of HP to heal through. Yeah, speaking of which, though. I like the uncovering map though. It's something I've never really done before, and it does make this feel like a kind of cool, unknown space. He's a machine! A lot of RMOs. Not that I want to deal with.
I'll be right back.
Not trying to get confused out here. It's not the life that I want. Yeah, so there's like a bunch of nodes, I guess, basically, that you can navigate between.
I'll be right back.
I will not be right back. Telling you that now. Now what? Weird waterfall thing? Okay. Ray. Oh, that hits everybody. Dang it. Guess we made it work. Bust these guys. Indeed. That is just taking casual like two turns in a row. He has truly started to come into his own. I love that for him. Put Rika back in, just because she always goes first, and so she can steal from random stuff. Even if I don't feel like fighting it in the longer term. I guess that just only makes me able to get silence proof. Maybe it gives me the silence strike as well. That'd be nice. XP is pretty good here though. Yeah, fish scale is what I need for those, I see. Yeah, that is what I use for the strikes. It's slow touch sound is messed up. I'm about it. I'm here for it. I need to break damage cap. I guess I haven't even seen the item yet, so I probably don't need to sweat it too much. Taxes once, I think we'll live. If I take enough turns, that's like having accuracy. Behemoth likes down here. Money guard from this thing, I assume. Yeah. Pray that this meteor is not enough to kill Totos, I think. Oh, goodness gracious. Aw, man, I shouldn't have risked it. I had good progress in there. Actually, when was the last time I said, oh, dang it. It might have actually been an awkward time. Oh wait, it was so long ago. Man, that stinks. Okay, let me look at the have the strength sphere or whatever from there. I can't remember what I, what do you call it? What I got out of the temple. I guess I need to take a break anyway, so I'll use that to also go back and look through the the VOD. Gotta figure out if I've already done this temple or not. I did forget to save after I went through this temple. It's a bummer. I'm mostly surprised I went all the way to, like, the Killika Temple without, saving. Or the Besaid Temple, because I went back to go talk to that Faith. And at no point, apparently, did I actually stop and save. Well, lesson learned. The Behemoth King Meteor means it. I assume it's magic damage, though, so if I just, like, shell up before I kill it, it'll be fine. Fortunately, these are all pretty fast temples once you know what you're doing. And especially, like, even more so when you aren't, like, exploring or trying to figure out what you need to do or what you might need to do. So I feel like I can actually kind of schmoof through this. This back anytime soon? I guess I do. Never mind, I do. I need to be able to push it off the cliff. Maybe I'll just go talk to the Faiths is the last thing I do tonight. So I need to go to... I guess I now need to go to the Sade again. To Killika, and then Makalania. I don't think I can get back to Bavel now. I think that ship has sailed. It was weird when I did go back to it to talk to Micah. It was just like, or I guess and Bahamut. It definitely felt like you kind of weren't supposed to have come back there. But maybe they wanted it for plot reasons, and so they're like, just make it playable again. And they're like, sure thing. But it's not like a real town, it's definitely just like the leftover parts of a dungeon kind of carved out. Glowing wall. I'm glad these were all pretty easy though. I was gonna be bummed if I had to do a bunch of shenanigans. I mean, just figuring out the puzzle the first time was kind of a pain. So, them being straightforward here is nice. I think the hardest part, though, is just figuring out, like, the weird leaps of logic they want you to make for the actual puzzles themselves, like... I mean, pushing the pedestal into the lightning is probably, like, the biggest just, like, you what moment. But I feel like a lot of the temples have their own just weird little Oh yeah, we just have this extremely specific thing we intend for you to do, and you just kind of have to guess it based on the fact that there's not that many things to interact with, so if you just sort of combine most of them with each other, you'll more or less get there. At least I don't have to redo this temple. These designs for, like, the Chamber of the Faith are so cool. I'm glad that, like, coming back to them is a good excuse to check them out again. Because I really like how they look. In the, like, the little crystal that has the Aeon in it, basically. Okay. I also was nervous because in the Besaid Temple, there were so many treasure chests, and I was like, did I somehow miss a bunch of these? Like, were there this many treasure chests in Jose? And there were not. So, really, it's a blessing in disguise that I got kicked out of Sin and lost all the progress, right? Or something. Something like that. Now we will save. And then, yeah, we'll do the lightning run through Besaid again and through Kilika. And then I guess I'll make the trek out to Mogalania to go talk to Shiva's Faith. I actually don't know how far it is from where I end up starting. I think it's kind of a ways though, because I think the only point I can jump to is Mogalania Woods, so I have to go all the way through the woods. And then all through the ice field or whatever. Which is annoying, but how it goes. I thought it might be a Albed primer.
I won't go so easy on you next time.
Just looking out for him. Oh yeah, I guess I can look at them in the key items. Does it tell me what the to and from is actually? Yeah, they said it does just teach you the language in order, A, B, C, D, blah, blah, blah. I have a lot of key items that I have not gotten, so... intriguing. Wait, there's the Mars Crest and the Mars Sigil. Huh. I have no idea what makes them different, but I guess they're two different things that I picked up at two different times. Completely on purpose. Yeah, this is just so weird to me. It's just like, whoop. No comment, just, be gone. To the walls. What do they have to tell me? It's interesting that they do try to, like, kind of bait you into using your, or like getting a destruction sphere. They're like, hey, look at this. So I think if you just use this in the first place you come across that you can use it, then that's when you get the destruction sphere. Like right there. I need to use the... it has to be the Basid sphere in here. It opens the door. I see. Oh, you basically have to get the destruction sphere. Oh no, you don't, because if you don't take the glyph sphere off the door, then you're empty-handed, and you can just take the Basid sphere and plug it in here. Did you want to investigate that destruction sphere? Too bad. That one is a bit more of like a feels bad gotcha. Because it's like not even obvious that you're about to finish the temple. It's just like, oh hey, you're
Sin is cursed. Sin sees
truth. You're just doing this thing. You're pushing this block, and now you have you've left, and we'll reset the dungeon on you. Yeah, this place is loaded up. I guess the white magic spheres are nice if I need to teach more people Kyogre or something. A holy maybe? I just missed the door. Alright. Now we save. Now we remember. Some people here talking about who's on the minds of the people. A flying ship. People love airships. It's just science. Listen, dude. I gotta explore. This guy's contract. Games, dang. Dude is around for ages. These guys got petrified grenades? They just hand those things out to anybody, huh? At least I didn't have to do any, like, re-hunting of monsters. That would have been the real big pain in the butt. I mean, I guess the ones in Sin off re-hunt, but... None of the, like, alright, I just have to fish for the random... one-off encounter in this area that I missed somehow. I just have to fish for that random one-off encounter in Sin. Let us assume so. I guess Bavel is the birthplace of... Not the birthplace of Machina, but certainly a place that used a bunch of Machina, so... In a roundabout way, it kind of is, right? Came full circle. Yeah, there's another one where they just, like, throw the destruction sphere at you. They're just like, hey, by the way, here's a destruction sphere. Although it's much more difficult to figure out what to actually do with it this time around. There's a place in here. I was like, I don't remember if there's somewhere to stick this sphere. Oh yeah, I need to use it to light the glyph. Oh, I need to... That's right, I need to go grab the... Thelica Sphere first. Make room! For the Glyph Sphere. Oh, I do need a Thelica Sphere for this. I thought there was one over here for some reason, but of course there wouldn't be. You need to demonstrate your understanding of creating burning doors. I mean, that just sounds so snarky. I actually did mean, like, it makes sense that they wouldn't put one here because the whole point of this is, like, it's a closed door. You need to bring the key. I was just Beside Temple that to load it up. Well, it's got some decent pulls in it. A bit of extra loot. I also want to see if I can go back to the bell. I don't think I can. Oh, but I do get to teleport right to Lake Makalania. That's a big dub. Wait, can I not get to the Makalania Woods normally? Oh, hybrid. Yeah, I can't go to the bell. This makes my life easier. See that Sin has fallen the bell. I'll talk to you. Keep them. Good little all bed lesson in there.
I will go so easy on you next time.
Bye. Actually, doing the temple and going to talk to the Faith is probably just enough time for what I want to do anyway. I thought I'd end up with like some awkward extra time, but it does not look like that's the case. So I guess next week we'll mostly just be poking around Sin. And then... I guess I still need to figure out what to do with how to get to the Maga Sisters. Eye potions. I gotta walk all the way around this long approach to the temple. Fortune, I think, is counter-free, at least, so. A silver lining. That's a kind of cool approach. You get to see it, like, hanging in this giant cave. It's hungry. Let's get started. Oh yeah, we gotta go use the glow sphere downstairs, yeah. This is the place I was thinking of with the basement. Oh yeah, that's the one I have to do last because I need the bridge in the meantime. Slide on over. Hmm. then, yeah, so I need to grab one more from up here. Leave the sphere. We did it. I did this one a bunch of times when I was trying. Oh yeah, because I kept accidentally resetting it when I was trying to get the destruction sphere. It was a whole pain in the butt. Wait, what? Oh yeah, because this is like, you have to escape afterwards. I always forget that it's weird that way. I assumed that it was like, surely you have to do the puzzle first, but it's actually not. Well, we speedrun it anyway. Just for funsies. For the flex. I'm gonna have to do it on the way out. That's the annoying catch. It was not a flex, it was practice.
Should the dreaming end, you too will disappear. Fade into spirit sea, spirit sky. But do not weep, nor rise in anger. Even we were once human. That is why we must dream. Let us summon a sea in a new dream world. A new sea for you to swim.
Magic sphere. All right, let's do this one more time. I guess technically putting a sphere in there and like maybe save me a move or two. So I picked up that sphere. upstairs that was like making that icicle formation. And I could have stuck it into the what do you call it? I guess I would have had to come back up for the glyph sphere anyway. So I'm making a trip back up kinda no matter what. And then similarly, since I can only hold one sphere, I have to make this trip down with that sphere no matter what. Or one of the two spheres I can grab. Easy peasy. No big deal. Freedom! I don't know if I can go back to the Bavel place and get the Faith there, but who knows. Anyway, good stuff.